Welcome back to Ritesh Tech Labs. So today I'm going to show you how you can install Hadoop in Linux system. So for today's purpose, we are going to use Ubuntu 20.04 as our Linux system. You can use another version of Ubuntu or any Debian based Linux. So let's start. So first of all, click on the bottom left corner of the Ubuntu to open the apps and search for terminal and right click on it. So when your terminal is open, we have to type in sudo apt update to update our repos links. So it will ask you for your password. So it may take a few seconds depending on your internet speed. So once it is done, now let's start installing OpenJDK Java version 8. So for this, type in the command sudo apt install openjdk -8-jdk and -y. So I have put all these commands in the video description, so you can also get these commands from there. So it may take few minutes on your system, again depending on your internet connection. So now clear the terminal and let's see if Java is installed or not by typing in java-version. So make sure that it's 1.8. So the last number doesn't matter to it too. Just make sure it's version 1.8. So now clear the terminal and our next step is to install OpenSSH server and clients. So for this, just type in the command sudo apt install openssh-server openssh client and -y. So now it is installed on our system. Now let's go to next step, that is create new user for Hadoop user. So first clear the terminal and type in sudo user add hdoop. So you can type any username for in place of hdoop. I'm using the hdoop user. So it will ask you for the password for that new user. Just type in the new password. So you have to type the password again. So just leave these fields blank, full name, book number and so on. Now press Y and hit enter. So a new user is created. Let's add our new user to a sudo group so that we can execute sudo commands. So for that, type in sudo usermod -a G space sudo space our username. So in my case it's hdoop. So now our user is added to a sudo group. Let's log in to our user account. Type su-hdoop and hit enter. So now it will ask you for the password for the hdoop user. So as you can see, we are now logged into hdoop user account. And before that we were in our existing account or previous account, and now we are in our hdoop new user account. So in our next step, we'll set a passwordless SSH for our Hadoop user. So for that, just copy paste this command from the file I have shared with you in the description and hit enter. So if you see the screen something like this, then that means the command executed successfully. So let's copy paste the next command, that is a cat this one, and hit enter. And again copy paste the next command, that is chmod, and hit enter. So now let's test the SSH connection. Type in SSH localhost and type in yes and hit enter. So if you see a screen something like this, that means you are connected to the localhost without any password. It is successful. Now let's exit from the user. So let's clear the terminal and our next step is to download and install the Hadoop. So just copy paste this command from the description. So we are going to use the Hadoop version 3.3.0. So it will take some time as it's a huge file of 478 MB. So I'm going to fast forward this video. So as you can see, now our file is downloaded. So you can verify the that the file exists by typing ls command. So you can see our file is here. So extract the file, just type in the command tar xzf and Hadoop, the name of the file. So it will take some time for extraction. Now to verify that the file is extracted, just type in the command sls and you can see there's a folder named Hadoop 3.3.0. Now we have to set up our environment variable. So for that, type in sudo nano.bashrc. So it will open this file. Now let's go to the end of the file and paste these lines. You can find these lines in the file I have shared in the description. And now to save the changes, press Ctrl plus X and hit Y key, then press Enter. Okay, so our file is now saved. So to refresh the changes from the bashrc file, type in source.bashrc and hit Enter. So now we have to make some changes in Hadoop environment script. So just type in the command and it will open a file. Now scroll down where you see java underscore home. And just erase the whole line and paste the line that I have shared with you and the commands file. Now again press Ctrl plus X, press Y and hit Enter to save the changes. Now type the command which javac to check the Java compiler path. Now copy the path from the terminal and type in readlink hyphen f space and paste the path you have just copied and hit Enter. So you will see something like this. So now we have to edit four files. So now copy and paste this command and scroll down to the configuration tag. Now hit Enter and create a space between those opening and closing tag of configuration and paste these lines from the file here. So we have to do the same thing for all the remaining three files. So one by one, just copy paste these commands, hit Enter, and then go between the configuration tab and paste these lines. So let me quickly do this. So this was our last file. So now clear the terminal and let's start the Hadoop. So before that, we have to format the HDFS partition. Type the command HDFS name node hyphen format and hit Enter. And make sure that you are executing this command as the Hadoop user, the user you have created. And if you see something like this, that means the command executed successfully. Now again, clear the terminal. Now to start the Hadoop processes, we have to type in the command start-all.sh and you will see a message attempting to start all Apache Hadoop daemons in 10 seconds. So after 10 seconds, you will see that it starts all the daemons. Daemons are actually the processes required by Hadoop. So the command executed successfully. So as you can see, our all the processes are started. If you type the command jpl, you will see that all these processes are running. Now to verify that our Hadoop is working, open the browser. And type in localhost colon 9870 and hit enter. So if you see a page something like this, then that means your Hadoop is working and you have successfully installed Hadoop on your Linux system. So let's see how we can stop this. So for stopping this, type in the command stop hyphen all.sh and hit enter. Again, it will take about 10 seconds. So after 10 seconds, it will start stopping all the daemons it has started. So as you can see, it started stopping all the daemons one by one. To verify the same, again use the JPS command and you will see that all the daemons are stopped. And you can also verify this by going back to the browser and click on the refresh. As you can see, it's saying unable to connect because our Hadoop daemon is stopped. So thank you guys for watching this video. If you like this video, then hit the like button and also subscribe for the future content.